Dear students, today we are going to learn about modal verbs, or simply we can say modals. Now the question is, what is a modal? Now, verbs are of two kinds based on their function. So verbs are of two types based on their function. Number first, main verbs are principal verbs, and number second, auxiliary verbs or simply we can say helping verbs. Now main verbs are principal verbs. For example, eat, drink, read, etc. They are main verbs or principal verbs. Auxiliary verbs or helping verbs, they are further of two types. Number first, primary auxiliary verbs. Primary auxiliary verbs. And number second, modal auxiliary verbs or modals. And this is our today's topic. Modal auxiliary verbs or we can say modals. Now primary auxiliary verbs are be, do and have, and modal auxiliary verbs are modals. They are 13 in number. They are can, could, may, might, will, would, shall, should, must, use to, need not, ought to, and dear. So these are modal auxiliary verbs, or we can say modals. In some current English grammar books, use to, need not, ought to, and dear, they are under a separate heading and they are called as semi-modals. But let us here consider them under a single heading, that is modal auxiliary verbs or modals. Now again the question is, what is a modal? A modal auxiliary verb, a modal auxiliary is a verb. A modal auxiliary is a verb used with another verb to express an idea, such as permission, possibility, certainty, obligation, which is not expressed by the main verb of the sentence. So a modal auxiliary is a verb used with another verb to express an idea. For example, permission, possibility, certainty, obligation, etc., which is not expressed by the main verb of the sentence. Now, for example, if I write here, you can go. Now, here the model is can, and it expresses the idea of permission. If we remove this model, then the verb go, it cannot express the idea of permission. And number second, models express the attitude of the speaker or writer. This is very important. Models express the attitude of speaker or writer. Models express the attitude of speaker or writer. Now, if I see somebody running, I can say he is running. So I can say he is running. Now, if I write here, he may run. Now here, the model is may. And he is not actually running. Here, the model expresses my attitude, what I think. So the model expresses the attitude of the speaker or writer. If I am the writer or the speaker here, when I say he may run, it expresses my attitude. That means what I think. That means he is able to run. Now, all modal verbs have some features in common. All modal verbs, they have some features in common. Number first, modal verbs have only one form. So modal verbs have only one form and do not inflect for person or number. Do not inflect for person or number. So there are some common features of all modal verbs. Number first is, all modal verbs have one form and do not inflect for person or number. Inflect means they do not change for person or number. For example, he can learn, we can learn, they can learn, you can find here that modal verbs are the same for all the pronouns, because there is only one form for all the modal verbs and they do not inflect for person or number, and these are examples show this. Number second feature, only the base form of the verb comes after the modal verb. So only the base form of the verb comes after modal verb. For example, if I write here, he could running fast. He could running very fast. Now here, only the base form of the verb comes after the modal verb. Here I have written, he could running fast, very fast. This is not the acceptable form. Now I want to correct this. I should write the base form of the verb. Now the correct form would be, he could run fast. So number second is only the base form of the verb comes after the modal verb. And number third, one modal verb can express several meanings. Number third, one modal verb can express several meanings. For example, take the example of the modal can. So one modal verb can express several meanings. Take the example of the modal verb can. Number first, can you lend me your book, please? Now here, the modal verb, it expresses the meaning of request. Number second, you can use the library if you wish. You can use the library if you wish. Now here, the modal verb can, it expresses the meaning of permission. Now this is the basic information about modal verbs or modals. In the next video, we shall discuss different modal verbs in detail. Thank you.